Joining us in studio tonight, former Saints All-Pro kick returner Tyrone Hughes, former NFL agent Doug Sunseri. Gentlemen, we have a lot to talk about. Let's get right to the report from the Washington Post, citing unnamed anonymous NFL sources. They say that Greg Williams and even perhaps Sean Payton and Mickey Loomis could be suspended 8 games this season for their involvement in the bounty hit scandal. Tyrone, what do you think of that?
I think it's ridiculous, Fletch. I mean, if you're going to investigate the New Orleans Saints, you're going to have to investigate the entire NFL because it's being done throughout the entire NFL. It's done by position, and I think everybody's getting caught up on the word bounty, as if Greg Williams held the money and just gave it out to these guys to say, hey, go take this guy out. First of all, it's done by position. Every position puts it up, even on the offensive guys. Offensive linemen put up money for if they get a pancake. You know, they'll get money out of the pot. You know, if you jump off sides, then you have to contribute money to the pot. So it's done by position. Most of the time, most coaches are holding the money because we don't want another player doing it.
But, Doug, isn't it fair to say, not to disagree with Tyrone, but I am going to disagree with Tyrone, the fact that it's against NFL rules and the players are the ones who are supposed to police the players, so therefore that is why they're in trouble because of this?
Well, I mean, I think there's two components. One, you got the salary cap and circumvention of the salary cap. When the salary cap came out in 1993, they had very stringent penalties for circumventing it in any way. I mean, really harsh, harsh penalties. And the other aspect, too, is just recently the integrity of the game, trying to give the appearance that they're player safety, concussions, and that sort of thing. And you sort of have that melded up into one, and this is probably going to be maybe the biggest scandal with the NFL since the Alex Karras, Paul Hornung suspensions for gambling.
And that was full seasons for both of those in 1964?
That's right. Absolutely. 1964.
Yes. Let's get back to that point, because what you were saying, I don't think anyone's disagreeing. We talked to Jim Miller, who was one of the executives when you were a member of the Saints. He says bounties have always been there, but isn't there some responsibility that the coaches and management have to take to prevent this? I think everybody knows it goes on, but they can't be part of it like they
are. Well, Fletch, again, we're getting caught up on the word bounty. It's not a bounty per se that you're just putting a hit out on a certain guy. The money is put up. Let's take the defensive backs, for example. The money is put up in a pot. If you drop a pass, and it's not just in games, it goes towards practice also. If you drop a pass in practice or an interception in practice, you have to contribute to the pot. If you make an interception in practice, you get money out of the pot. At the end of the day or at the end of the year, what's done is whatever money is left in the pot, basically, as a group, you go out to dinner or have a party with it. So, again, I think everybody's getting caught up on the word bounty as if, okay, we put a hit out on Brett Favre. And, I mean, there's so many people out there talking about, well, the Saints cheated by doing this. And I have to disagree because I can't say you circumvent the cap with only a few $100s. I mean, although the money had grown to possibly $50,000 because obviously they didn't make their goals or do things that they were supposed to do in practice. But, again, it's not just – and first of all, you don't get paid for a cheap shot. So if that's being done or if that was done in a game and it was not between the whistle, then you don't get the money out of it anyway. So it defeats the purpose.
Obviously, this is a hot-button topic. I think that you see players that side with you that say this happens in the NFL and every team should be punished. But obviously, it goes without saying that the Saints are going to be made an example of because of this. How stiff do you think this will be? You alluded to the case in 1964. I doubt these guys get the full season. Let's just start very quickly. Greg Williams.
I think he's probably done for a half season. If not more. I mean, he could be suspended conceivably for the entire year.
Sean Payton.
I would guess 8 games, 4 to 8 games would
and
be
Mick,
a good guess.
Mickey Loomis.
Probably more because he's the head general manager, so possibly 8 games.
Let's talk a little bit about the other hot-button topic, as if this topic wasn't big enough, Drew Brees' contract not getting done. I'll go to Tyrone second and Doug first, since you were an agent. Is it perplexing a little bit that they've been working on this for a year and they couldn't get it done?
Well, most contracts get done at the deadline, but I would think you'd have had the parameters sort of set so that when you came to the deadline, you'd be very, very close. And that's one of the things that I was sort of surprised about, that they didn't close the parameters and be in a position to strike, because they actually put the franchise tag on yesterday. They didn't have to do it till tomorrow. So they knew the deal wasn't going to get done. But I think as far as the Saints are concerned, if they would have got the deal done, they could have probably saved Knicks and They're going to have a problem keeping Knicks now.
Now, isn't the deadline, I thought, was March 13th?
Well, March 13th is when free agency starts. The deadline to put a franchise tag on a player is tomorrow.
Okay, great.
So they obviously didn't even negotiate today. They just slapped the franchise tag on him on Saturday.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you surprised that this deal isn't done? I just to share my opinion, I'm surprised they didn't give Brees what he wanted. If anybody seemingly deserved what he was asking for, it was Drew Brees, who was underpaid compared to Peyton Manning and Tom Brady the last few years. A guy who's meant so much on and off the field.
Well, I totally agree with you, and I think Drew Brees needs to be paid as the top player in the NFL. However, it's still a business, and Mickey Loomis and Tom Benson and the organization still needs to be able to pay other guys and have a team. So they're looking at it, I'm assuming they're looking at it as, look, and again, it should have been talked about throughout this year to say, okay, even when they've gotten to this point, we can't afford to pay you as a top guy in the NFL, but work with us and we'll come back next year. But that's going to be a whole lot of trust on Drew Brees' part to deal with that.
I didn't get a quick rapid fire with you, so before we go, let me just ask you. You heard what Doug was talking about. How shocked would you be if Sean Payton got suspended between 4 and 8 games for the bounty hits? I know you don't like the word.
I would be very surprised. I mean, because if I didn't know, or if it has been illegal to do, then... And it's been going on, and the NFL knows this has been going on. I think it should be a situation where they're saying, look, guys, from here on out, let's not do this anymore. Organizations, let's cut it, you know, just end it. And from here on out, this is what the penalties would be. I don't think they should just come out right now and say, hey, look, New Orleans Saints, you guys, we're slapping this penalty on you right now.
All right. I think that's what's going to happen, though.
Yeah, that's right.
All right. Doug Sunseri, Tyrone Hughes, we appreciate your time. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Thanks a lot.